And chapter number 8, verses 1 through 5. Deuteronomy chapter number 8, verses 1 through 5. And I will give this disclaimer that I'm not going to get finished. I'm just going to stop at a good stopping point. As they used to say in the old Batman movies, TV show, they said, tune in next week to the same bat channel, the same bat station. We'll be doing the same thing. So if it be the Lord's will, we'll pick up where we leave off today. Man, on next week. Deuteronomy chapter 8, verses 1 through 5. The Bible declares, and the commandment which I command thee this day shall ye observe to do, that ye may live and multiply and go in and possess the land which the Lord sware unto your fathers. And thou shalt remember all the way. This is what I want. This is what I want us to begin to focus on. Verse 2. Thou shalt remember all the way which the Lord thy God led thee these 40 years in the wilderness. Why? To humble thee. And to prove thee, and to know what was in thine heart, whether thou wouldest keep his commandments or no. And he humbled thee, and suffered thee to hunger, and fed thee with manna, which thou knewest not, neither did thy fathers know, that he might make thee to know that man doth not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God doth man live. Thy raiment, not old, not waxing old upon thee, neither did thy foot swell. My God, look at what God has done to make sure his people were taken care of. He says, not only did your raiment not wax old upon you, neither did your feet swell these 40 years. Thou shalt also consider in thine heart that as a man chasteneth his son, so the Lord thy God chasteneth thee. Thus be the reading of the word of the Lord. I'm going to stop right there. I want to talk to us today from this subject of lessons from the wilderness. Lessons from the wilderness. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Lord, do it in Jesus' name. Amen. Lessons from the wilderness. I will admit, as I open with this statement, that it is one thing of wonder and amazement for us to be able, or shall I say for me personally, to be able to look back and to consider and to remember just how God has miraculously delivered us, delivered me. When I speak of that, I'm speaking collectively and more so individually. To see how God has delivered my life, brought me out of a world of sin and shame, and delivered me from the clutches of the enemy, it is a miraculous thing to even consider how, before I even recognized God, even acknowledged God, I was in the mind of God, amen, and God was thinking about me. As amazing as it is to consider this, I would like to add to that statement that it is also quite another thing that we ought to review the typography of our lives as we have journeyed in our walk with God to a better place. In other words, it's wonderful to be able to consider, for some of us, God had delivered us many years ago, amen, from addictions. God had delivered some of us many years ago from the clutches, amen, of a jail cell or a prison cell or a lengthy sentence. It's amazing to consider, amen, how God has delivered and even constructed and in some cases reconstructed our families, amen, and saved our lives. And while that is a great amazement. I believe that it is just as amazing when we pause in our perspective to consider the typography of where God has brought our lives from after we came to know the Lord. I know that some would perhaps want us to think, amen, that the greatest deliverances that have happened in our lives happened before, man, we came to know the Lord. And I believe that is true. I believe, man, that is one of the greatest deliverances that we've ever experienced in our lives and in our journey and our walk with God. But the reality is that we need to pause at times in our lives and really consider just how far God has brought us. I can hear Lee Williams and the spirits of QCs. I can't help it. I'm country, y'all. Never got to let me be myself. I can hear Lee Williams and the spirits of QCs. He began to sing, and he sang about the faithfulness of God and how that he was discouraged at the mountain that he was facing before him. But when he turned around, he looked back, he said, all I can see is hills, more hills. And it began to remind me and make me realize, man, of all the difficult things God had already brought me through. Need to pause for a minute and tell somebody that is under the sound of my voice that may be going through today that God did not bring you this far to leave you. Yes, Lord. I know that Corona has some of us shut up in our homes. I know, man, we're facing some very difficult financial situations and possibly some very dark days, but I came to tell the people of God, the children of God, that God did not bring us this far to leave us. Amen. Even as we consider the mountaintop experience and even the valley floor experiences of our journey and our walk with God, man, Jeremiah tells us, I might as well do what I came to do now. Jeremiah came to tell us, man, in Jeremiah 29, man, chapter 11, he says, I know the thought that I think towards you, saith the Lord. Man, I want somebody to just put it in the comment section real quick. Man, it does not matter what you're facing right now. Put it in the comment section. Amen. Just stick to the plan. I want you to understand that it's time to stick to the plan of God. Thank you, Lord. Begin to look at this text. You have to begin to consider, man, this scripture. As I begin to look at it, we find the people of God. I ain't got a lot of time here. Find the people of God now. How they have found themselves now at the brink of the Jordan River after having been in the wilderness for some 40 years. Bible declares to us, amen, and simply put, man, that the people of God now have come out of Egypt in their exodus and have found themselves on their way to the promise of God in their lives. Well, while they're on their way, they must encounter the wilderness. And perhaps there's somebody that's watching me today. You yourself have found yourself in a wilderness situation. You may ask, Pastor, what are you talking about? When you're talking about experiencing the wilderness, well, the wilderness may be a financial, a material, a physical, or an emotional burden that seems to be pressing sore against your soul. It is in these periods of wilderness somebody would put it in the comment section now, that the devil is a liar, and he is the father of a lie. Thank you, Lord. When we encounter now the wilderness, I'm almost where I'm trying to get now, when we encounter these experiences and period of the wilderness, quite often, frequently, we find ourselves, my God, drawing back into a place of seclusion and isolation. I got to talk about my own self now. When I found myself encountering, my God, a desolate place, a dry place in my spirit, a place of great pressing and frustration, I didn't want to be around everybody. He went out there trying to escape wrong actions and wrong motives. I wish I could tell y'all that the reason, that the only reason we find ourselves in the wilderness is because God sends us there all the time. But the reality is sometimes I'm in the wilderness because of my own choices. I'm out here because of my own actions. He sent Jethro for the Bible in class in Exodus chapter
rescued you. And he asked this question, why have you left him where you left him? And the Bible declared that Jethro, he called Moses into his house. Because I suggest to us today that God realized that what Moses needed as he entered into that wilderness was not a good message. Because he was struggling with his identity. Moses didn't need a prophecy.
That they had
got to learn not to groan and complain. It's easy, y'all, to forget to be thankful and to give God praise when your circumstance doesn't seem conducive.
Lesson number two of the wilderness. got to learn to be thankful and worship. I believe it's significant for the lady, my God, when we look at Israel's expedition, my God, through the wilderness, how we see that it's bookend. My time is gone. There's a quote by Darlene Shittum in her book, Worship Changes Everything. She said, by speaking God's word in the wilderness, we find deliverance. In the wilderness, it is a discipline to keep from continuously talking about our problems. But if we do keep talking about our problems, we find ourselves wandering in a circle longer than we should have been as we step into victory. She said, even if the feelings aren't there, we can still acknowledge God's presence with a praise and thanksgiving. For by God's grace, we are still able to worship. I'm going to leave you with the words of an old song. Some of y'all know it. It said, in shady green pastures, so rich and so sweet, God leads his dear children along. Where the waters cool flow, bathe the weary one's feet. God leads his dear children along. Alone. Want you to be encouraged in these lessons from the wilderness. Amen. God has a plan for your life. He has a reason that you're where you are in this season. Want you to buckle down and hold on to God. Don't find yourself in isolation and seclusion. But just like Moses needed somebody to hold his arms up, Aaron and Hur had to hold his arms up so he could get the victory. God is bringing people into your life, connecting them to you, that you might experience the victory God has promised your life. If you're watching today, I gotta stop. If you're watching today, you don't know the Lord Jesus in the pardon of your sins. If you're watching today and you've not experienced the luxury of having him not only walk with you through difficult times, but essentially carrying you when you couldn't even have the strength to walk. In her book, Worship Changes Everything. She said, by speaking God's word in the wilderness, we find deliverance. In the wilderness, it is a discipline to keep from continuously talking about our problems. But if we do keep talking about our problems, we find ourselves wandering in a circle longer than we should have been as we step into victory. She said, even if the feelings aren't there, we can still acknowledge God's presence with a praise and thanksgiving. For by God's grace, we are still able to worship. I'm going to leave you with the words of an old song. Some of y'all know it. He said, in shady green pastures, so rich and so sweet, God leads his dear children along. Where the waters cool flow, bathe the weary one's feet. God leads his dear children along. Some through the waters,
alone. Want you to be encouraged in these lessons from the wilderness. Amen. God has a plan for your life. He has a reason that you are where you are in this season. Want you to